once again, everybody, I'm Jeff. Welcome to the Gridiron. You know, we do a little coverage of some of the seasons past in the NFL. This week we visit the year of 1979. Coming a lot more in the future. Last week, I believe, it was 1925, so going back in the future quite a bit. 1975, what a fine year indeed it was. There were a total of 28 teams, each team playing 16 games. We start off first in the NFC. Powerhouses such as the Los Angeles Rams, Dallas Cowboys, still made it to the playoffs. And there were a couple surprises. The Chicago Bears have made it in. So did the Philadelphia Eagles as wild cards. But perhaps the biggest surprise of all, and far and away the biggest surprise, had to be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who wound up winning their division with a record of 10-6. Let's not forget, Tampa Bay entered the league in 1976, and they managed to lose their first 26 games in a row. They came to the league in 76, and it wasn't until 1977, the second last game, 1977, before they won their first game. And here it is, 2 years after that, that lonely 77 season, Tampa Bay not only was a success, but they won their division, and they made it to the playoffs. Tampa Bay managed to make it all the way to the NFC Championship game, where they hosted the Los Angeles Rams. The Rams, however, were far too the superior team. Tampa Bay had a phenomenal defense. Their offense usually just scored just enough points to get them the victory, as the defense would hold the opponent to a manageable amount of points. And in the NFC Championship game, in an unusual type of score, the Los Angeles Rams won 9-0, propelling the Rams to their first Super Bowl. Over in the AFC side, the Miami Dolphins won the AFC East. The San Diego Chargers won the AFC West. And, no surprise here, Pittsburgh Steelers won the AFC Central. And in the AFC, the wildcard teams were the Denver Broncos and the Houston Oilers, led by Earl Campbell. And those same Houston Oilers made it to the championship game in the AFC, where they played Pittsburgh Steelers in Pittsburgh. Now, with Pittsburgh holding a slim 17-13 lead in the fourth quarter, Pittsburgh managed to score the final 10 points of the game to pull away and secure a victory, 27-13, once again propelling the Pittsburgh Steelers into the Super Bowl, where they played the Los Angeles Rams. The Los Angeles Rams would face the Pittsburgh Steelers in Super Bowl 14. In Pasadena, California, on January 20th, 1980, in front of a crowd of well over 103,000 people, the Rams would hold a slim 13-10 lead at halftime. Both teams would score a touchdown in the third quarter. However, the Rams would miss their extra point. So this would give the Rams a slim 19-17 lead heading into the fourth quarter. And at this point, entering the fourth quarter is when the Steelers played, once again, like champions. Almost 3 minutes into the fourth quarter, John Stallworth would catch a 73-yard touchdown pass, giving the Steelers a 24-19 lead. The Rams would get the ball back, and with just under 9 minutes left to go in the game, the Rams would start off at their own 16-yard line. They would drive until they got to the Pittsburgh Steelers 32-yard line. Unfortunately for the Los Rams, Vince Ferragamo threw a pass and was picked off by future Hall of Famer Jack Lambert. Once the Steelers got the ball back, Terry Bradshaw would use a long pass completion to John Stallworth and a pass interference penalty against the Rams to help them get another touchdown, as Franco Harris would rush in from 1 yard out, giving the Steelers a 31-19 lead, and they would wind up winning Super Bowl 14, 31-19. It would be the Steelers' fourth Super Bowl victory in the 70s. Unfortunately for them, it would be their last Super Bowl victory for quite some time. Well, that's all the time I have for this week. What year are we going to visit next week? Well, you have to come back and see. Thanks for watching. I'm Jack. And remember, we're going to see you on the gridiron.